See that? He was in tighter too. Not 8 foot. In this stuff. Close to the weeds. Yeah, I thought for a sec, I thought, oh no. El Piquio. Oh, I just missed another one. Got him. Oh, another one. Not that time. Oh yeah, another good one. Look at that. How many are there? How many times did he eat it? Wow, hey. Tell you what I'm gonna do. What a waypoint right there. Oh, look at him go. Look at him go. You got line you can pull. That's it. You can see him below my boat. Look him on the sonar. That's him. You say to yourself, wow, look at all the fish below the boat. That's just him shaking his head all around. No, oh, good. Goodness me. How many times you hit that, huh? Was it you or was it a buddy? How many times? Hard to tell. 2, 3. Oh boy. He's got that all over the place. Good thing that net is just... Once you get them, make sure you got them. That's all I say. You commit, commit. And you won't get bit by them hooks. Another decent fish, eh? In a box, like I said, a few more, then we'll put them back. Move around a bit, put them back. Just solid, nice thick fish. But that was probably one shot, two shots. Third time, unlucky for him. But you know what? My gut instinct is telling me, I think there's more fish there because I just caught one there. I put it back in the same spot, real close. Maybe they're schooling a little bit tighter to those weeds. I'm out about 9.5 feet. And when I came by this last pass, I made some casts into that 8, 8.5, crank, 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 because that crankbait dives to 8 to 10 feet. So you know it's going right through where they are, drives them nuts. If they're in any kind of schooling mode, or there's more than, you know, 2 or 3 fish, it just inspires them to, boom, eat it. Let's go.